Today I'm going to show you how to winterize this RV using antifreeze, and we're gonna achieve this project by spending, I guess, two gallons of antifreeze costing about $7. We can finish this whole project. A couple of easy steps that we will start with. The first thing is to drain all the lines, like draining the fresh tank, draining the water heater, bypassing the water heater, and draining water through the lowest points. We're gonna achieve one by one. To begin with, we will first go and show you how to bypass the heater, okay? The water heater. So here is the water heater panel. Now I'm gonna briefly explain the pipes. So this is a cold water pipe, which is, this is where the water is coming from. It comes like this and it goes, and then it goes into the water heater. The water heater heats the water and pumps it through this hot valve, and then it goes into the faucets. So this valve is right now open so that cold water can go in. This valve is open so that hot water can come out, and this bypass valve is closed at the moment, so there is no water passing through this. All right, so what we're gonna do now, to so that before we winterize, we do not want the antifreeze to run into the water heater. So I'm gonna close this valve right here. So this is closed, so no more cold water going in. This is also closed, so that way no more hot water or no more antifreeze goes in through any other valve. And then I'm gonna open this valve, okay? That way the antifreeze comes from here, it goes in here, it goes, and then it goes into the hot pipe, and it does not go into the water heater. So this setup is enough for us to assume that there is no more water going into the water heater, no more antifreeze when we actually start the pump and run the antifreeze. So this is basically how we bypass the water heater. So with this valve open, both hot and cold become one, basically. So let's go out now and let's drain the water heater. Actually, drain the water heater, basically for that we have to release this valve out here. We have to open this, and that will start letting the water go. So before we do that, we will first do the bypass, okay, going inside. This is slightly tricky to access this, so we need a long thing to hold this, actually. So we're gonna, yep, we got there, and we're gonna release this. Before you want to do this, make sure that the heater was not running, that way you don't have hot water hitting you and no casualties there. So I'm gonna release this now. So pretty good amount of water will start flowing. Wait, can you hold the camera?
Yeah.
Just hold it, okay? So the water would flow and it is absolutely fine. Let all the water go out of the water heater. Drop by drop, it will take a long time. Let it take its sweet time. Is to access to the water tank, that way we can drain it. In this specific RV, there is a valve near the water tank that we're gonna open, that way all the water will pass through that. So I'm gonna take these cushions off and get to the water tank. There are some small areas where my hands cannot reach. I brought in my champion son, Mr. Kruger, who's gonna get his hands into the small pockets and open this valve. You see this red valve? Do you see that?
Yeah.
You have to turn that on to open side. Open. Okay.
Oh.
We are, if you see, we are draining the water from the tank. Every RV is different in the way you drain the water. We have it here. It has a valve inside. So we're gonna let this go all the way. Let all the water go, and then we're gonna get to the next step. This is actually the water draining from the fresh tank. We had a valve inside, we released it. So this is one important step to easily drain all the water from the water tank. Lowest points in the pipes, in the water pipes, because in spite of draining all the water everywhere, you will still have some water left in the pipes, and you do not want that. So I'm going to get to the lowest points of the pipes. I'm going to release them. That way we have absolutely no water anywhere in the system. For this RV, the pipes are located in here, under this, if you see these two, right, these are the two pipes, the lowest points in the RV, and we're going to release them. That way there is no water absolutely anywhere in the system.
So
that's the lowest point in the water pipe system. When we actually run the antifreeze, we also want to make sure that the antifreeze is coming out of this pipe as well. Okay, these two pipes, you see, those are currently open at the moment. Is to actually pour and fill some antifreeze in this, but we need a funnel. Do you have any idea what we're gonna do if we don't have a funnel?
Probably just get a bottle and then just get scissors, and then you can cut the bottom of it. I can show you where to.
Okay, show me once, please.
So first you need to get a bottle.
Okay.
And then you need to cut this.
Okay.
And then you have to get all this off so you can
see. Sure, we're gonna use that as a funnel, right?
Yeah,
and then it is about $3.50. And it says here this product is considered to be gas, which is generally regarded as safe by the Food and Drug Administration, which means even if the funnel is ready, before we pour water into the tank, we're gonna first close the drain plugs for both the tank as well as the lowest points. So let's get to the lowest point and close that. That way we only want the antifreeze to go out when we test it. We start using the RV back in the summer. After a couple of rounds of rinsing of the entire water system, it's safe for us to start using it back. So this particular antifreeze is pretty acceptable from the FDA. Don't shake it, okay, please?
Okay.
Hey, no, come
You want to cut out the top layer so that it doesn't come to work.
We keep some for some purpose. There is a need for it. Okay, so this should be more than sufficient to run all the pipes with antifreeze. Okay, so let's go in now. With some antifreeze in that, we're gonna run the pump and start letting the antifreeze flow from each faucet, both hot and cold. So let's begin with the one which is all the way in the bathroom. Okay, come for it. So let's begin with this. Initially it will start flowing the water, and then you'll start getting the antifreeze. That's antifreeze for you, right? See? Now let's do the hot, the other faucet. Do you see that? Yep, right there. Stop that. So now we're gonna do the shower. Can you pray, can you hold this video?
Yeah.
Okay. First let's do the cold.
Do you see the water?
Do you see the antifreeze coming? Is it? Yep. You can see that color, right?
Pink.
Yep. Yep. water, 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 and now the antifreeze, right? Ready? Okay, so we're done with the bathroom. No, break, come here. Let's start doing this. Let's keep doing this till we get pink liquid. You see that? Yep. Now let's do the kitchen faucet.
So first it'll be white and then it'll go pink.
Yep. Okay, do you see that?
Yellow pink.
Now let's turn it on the other side. White, water, 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 and now you see the
pink.
Now you see the antifreeze, right? So let's now we need to also remember to let some antifreeze run from the lowest points. If you remember, it was on the back, right? Let's go there. Okay, do you see the pink liquid? Yep. The other one too. You see that?
That means that your antifreeze is in
everywhere, in all the points, right? Sure that we have enough antifreeze in the P-traps. Right? The P-traps should have enough antifreeze, so
pour in there.
Let's also pour into this pump. No, don't flush. Let's pour some in here. Antifreeze stays in the pee traps.
So me and Vivek have finished this whole project for $7 by buying 2 bottles of antifreeze, and this RV that you see here is fully ready for the winter, and we're gonna park it in one of our parking areas for all the winter. We are all good, and see you back in summer. Thank you. Say something.